first press. Are we ready? Do you have your seats? Asseyez-vous. It's first press. I am joined with the legend that is Anthony B.
Good times.
Thank you for being here. Thank you for coming to have a chat.
Good times, Anthony.
Is this your first time here at Reggae Sunstar?
No.
You've played before.
Yeah.
How does it compare to the last time?
Greater. The response was great and the people love it. So that's what we're here to do. Let the people enjoy themselves. So understand, give them a little understanding of what our music is about. So I think they get that message tonight. Love yourself, man. So I love it. The audience was great. Reggae Sunstar and our world is a great festival. The backstage is great, on stage is great.
What about the press tent?
That's what I'm coming to now.
Oh, good, good.
Yeah, it's a wonderful press tent, you know.
Thank you.
Mais alors c'est pas sa première fois ici au Reggae Sunstar, et pour comparer les fois précédentes et celle-là, ça va toujours de mieux en mieux. C'est toujours de plus en plus grand et l'accueil du public est vraiment énorme pour tout ce qu'ils font dans la musique. Et il apprécie particulièrement tous les côtés de la scène, derrière, devant, et la tente presse aussi particulièrement.
And you must have played in France throughout your career quite a few times, and in France they particularly love your music. What does it mean to you to be here with the French people?
Great, great. France have a great history, and I'm a lover of history. France is a country that is rich in history. Even in the role that we play today, being conscious, you know, the first thing we learn about, the first revolution we learn about, is the French Revolution.
Il a souvent joué en France et il apprécie particulièrement la France pour son histoire. Elle a une histoire très, très forte et très ancienne. Et le reggae est toujours, encore une fois, une musique de révolution. Et la première révolution dont ils entendent parler en Jamaïque, c'est la révolution française.
Yes.
And for you mentioned about conscious lyrics and things. Why is it important for you to bring consciousness within your music and for the people that listen to it?
Life itself is a conscious thing, you know. It is so complicated, it takes mankind a lifetime trying to understand life, and that is consciousness. We try to emphasize on consciousness, because consciousness is not only about yourself, where you're coming from historically, but about your well-being, the way you eat, the way you drink, the way you think. The way you live your life is also a part of consciousness, being conscious, and that affect, because life is like a domino effect. So the way you live reflect in your community become the society become the country become the nation. So everything
oui, la raison pour laquelle il fait des chansons avec des paroles qui amènent à une prise de conscience, c'est surtout parce que la vie elle-même est elle-même un processus conscient. La façon dont vous vivez, dont vous pensez, où vous habitez, tout ce que vous faites, ça doit être un processus conscient que vous devez intégrer.
Tell us about what it was like for you growing up, and I guess in particular finding the Rastafari religion and finding that sort of way of life, because I think for you that wasn't how you were, where you were born, you know, and how did your family receive that?
Well, growing up in Jamaica, it's rough, because we grow where we call the ghettos, and in the ghettos it's like that's a fence. So that's a home fence. In that little surrounding near that to that, that's your life. You understand? So you might go to a school and get a very great education. You are very well qualified for any job in society. But if you say that's where I'm from,
yeah.
So that's our life become rough for us. It was not our choice, or our parents' choice to have us there, but circumstances and situations. Poverty was handed down to us. So Rastafari, that's why Bob Marley is not just a singer to us. He's a hero. Because he created that road that we could look and say, oh, okay.
Yes, there's a way through.
There is a way through this suffering. So it's a rough growing up in Jamaica. Rastafari is our saving grace.
Oui, alors grandir en Jamaïque n'est pas une chose facile. La base qui pourrait être une palissade pour délimiter votre jardin, ce serait juste un bout de quelque chose pour séparer deux espaces. Et le rastafarianisme est en fait une des meilleures choses qui nous soit arrivée dans les ghettos jamaïcains. Qui a permis de nous faire développer. Et c'est un choix que nous et nos enfants devons prendre.
And for younger generations coming up, do you try to show them the path as Bob Marley did with your music? Is that your intention to be an example?
That's what I'm trying my best to do, and that's why I'm not only trying to sing conscious music, but I'm trying to entertain.
Yes.
Because if you want to impress the kids, you have to be an entertainer.
Right.
You understand? So I try to be an entertainer that young kids will always come around. So once they are your audience, then you can talk to them. They will listen to your music. You understand? It's like that young kid come up and he say, "Freedom Fighter." So you see, because if you didn't like Anthony Lee, then you wouldn't get to even know about freedom fighter.
Exactly.
Understand? So that's my whole aim. That's why I try to entertain and inform and educate. You know, that's what I try to do.
Et alors, il essaye toujours d'être un exemple pour les générations futures. Il essaye d'attirer tous les enfants qui pourraient s'intéresser à ces textes, mais principalement en offrant du divertissement. C'est en étant un performeur qui peut en fait attirer les personnes sur ces textes et sur le message qu'il veut faire passer.
I think I will use this opportunity now. This is how we do it in the press tent. We'll open it up to the audience members if anyone has a question for you.
Yeah.
Is there a question here? We've got one over there, that's my friend! It's going the long way round. We have a question for you.
Hello.
Listen.
Anthony, you put fire on stage. We saw you right now, so give thanks for that.
Give thanks a lot.
You're singing Freedom Fighters. For you, what is a freedom fighter really from the heart? And what are you doing apart from your singing to be a freedom fighter? And for you, how should we educate the youth so that they become conscious and aware?
Yeah, the first step to be a freedom fighter is to be conscious, because this is not the fight with guns and knives and bombs. That's not fight for freedom. That's what been going on for centuries and centuries, and it's not taking us to a better solution. So freedom for me now is the Olympics. Everyone playing a part, different country, different religion, different race, but they put that aside. They are very competitive, but physical, energetic, but no one is getting hurt and everyone is having fun. So there is a platform there. Imagine a country like the Olympics, where everyone is just being competitive at the highest level, being energetic, but you're not killing anyone, you don't discriminate against anyone, you know. So that's what I think freedom is, like the Olympics, like the World Cup, like the Euro Cup, like a festival.
And can you offer us a small jingle for that?
Well, the solution is us. My first saying to the people is, if we are not a part of the problem, then we can't be a part of the solution. So the first step to solution is to take the blame that we are a part of the problem, and then we can be the solution. There is no president, prime minister, kings, general, who is powerful without us. We, millions of us, say you are the president, then you are the president. Tomorrow you can ruin the world, but who give you that opportunity? 1 million people. So the solution comes from taking the blame. So that's where I see the solution. Well, us have to be the problem, then we can be the solution. If we keep pointing finger and say it's the president, it's the, we make president, we make kings, we make entertainers, we make superstars. We, the people. If no one is in the Olympic, then no one is watching. You understand? So the people. And that's why the system create mind control. So take back your mind. That's why my message is now love yourself. When you start loving yourself, then it's hard to trick a person who loves yourself. You ain't gonna waste your time, you ain't gonna waste your effort, you ain't gonna waste what you earn. You're gonna see, if I make a little money, I'm not gonna spend it because the TV say I should, or because the commercial say I should. I'm gonna look at necessity, needs. Our foreparents used to live like that. It's not strange to you, man. You couldn't get our great-grandfather to go and buy something if it's not necessary.
We don't
know. No, we buy out of wants, nothing. We just buy how we like. So it's time to stop, follow along. Check. Why should I? Where is he going? Where is this going? Check. Just like we check on our kids. What you're doing, we need to check ourselves too. So I think that's the solution, checking ourselves.
Oui, alors le concept du freedom fighter, du combattant pour la liberté, c'est pas un combat violent, c'est pas un combat physique, c'est quelque chose de personnel, individuel, qui doit passer d'abord par la reconnaissance de nos propres fautes. On fait partie du problème, alors on doit faire partie de la solution aussi. Donc il a pris beaucoup d'exemples pour essayer d'illustrer ça. C'est toute une transformation personnelle qui doit s'opérer.
Is there just in front of you, Nico?
Another question there.
Bonsoir, je vais poser ma question en français.
Bien sûr.
Concrètement, quel message avez-vous à faire passer au public qui vous écoute, c'est-à-dire à la diaspora noire africaine et aussi internationale? Quel message avez-vous à faire passer justement à l'intérieur de vos chansons par rapport à la situation actuelle de l'Afrique qui est aujourd'hui catastrophique?
So what's the message that you want to pass on for the black community, especially in Africa? What do you think of the situation in Africa right now?
Well, the situation in Africa is the same globally. Accept each man as my brother and each man as my friend. If I don't accept that I need help, then I won't get help. That's that solution come with realization, acknowledgement that, and Africa, we just keep saying we want the freedom, but we have to come together first. If my house is not together, then I can't call someone to come and help me. I have to show some form of blueprint, some form of map framework. Africa problem is not a big problem. It's just the same globally. Realization, if we keep slipping away from nature and going to human nature, then we're gonna lose it. Because human nature cannot govern nature. Nature governs human nature.
Oui, alors la situation en Afrique, en fait, une situation, c'est la même pour tout le monde, internationalement. La première chose à faire, c'est de s'accepter tous les uns les autres comme des frères et de se réunifier. La situation en Afrique est en fait identique un petit peu partout. Le problème de l'humanité aujourd'hui, c'est que tout le monde tout le monde se concentre sur la nature humaine et perd le lien avec la nature elle-même. L'homme ne peut pas diriger la nature, c'est la nature qui dirige l'homme.
Alors, désolé, en bon français. Alors, en 93, j'ai acheté votre premier album. Je rappelle, je ne suis pas si vieux que ça. Donc, votre tout premier album, a su contenir le feu qui avait, le feu qui brûlait en moi, qui me rendait fou. Juste vous poser une question, de quoi vous rêvez aujourd'hui? De quoi en rêve Anthony B? De quoi pour l'avenir en fait?
So he bought your first album in 1993 and he was really struck by the album. It contained all his fire, his aggressivity. And he's just got one question. It's basically would like to know what you dream about for the future. What's your dream for the future?
And my dream is to see humanity getting back to humanity. That's my greatest dream.
Son grand rêve, c'est de voir l'humanité retourner vers l'humanité. C'est son plus grand rêve.
Well, thank you very much for your questions, and I'd just like to thank you, Anthony B, for joining us here at the press. So please.